Hi there, this is Mina once again and welcome to our TT videocast. So in today's video, we are going to take a look at how to get started with audiobooks, or basically how to consume any information in form of listening instead of reading it. Now it is one of those videos that comes from my own personal experience and years of observation. So even if you don't find it helpful immediately, you will definitely find it useful in long run. So with that being said, let's get started. Okay, now before we get started, let us first see why you should listen to stuff instead of reading it. And well, there are certain advantages of that. Like for me, it is mostly about speed. So listening to audiobooks or a blog post is much quicker and you can consume a lot more information in less time. For instance, an average 300 page book, which usually take a month for normal people to finish, is only about 5 hours long when you convert it in audiobook, which can be easily read in few weeks, right? And the another thing that I like about audiobook is the conveniency. So listening to stuff is a lot more convenient than reading it, especially in the odd places. Like for instance, it is hard to read your favorite book while you are driving or in the public transport, but listening to them is very practical. And then there are many other reasons. Like you can put thousands of audiobooks in a single device and then you can listen it anywhere and anytime you want. But with physical books, it is not possible. Now obviously, you cannot apply this method everywhere you want. There are things that can only be read and not listened to. But for most of the stuff, this technique works. So let's see how it does. Tip number 1. Use pocket. So let's say you have a lengthy, well-researched article that you want to read, but apparently you don't have a time to read it. So in that case, you can use the pocket app to listen to it. All you have to do is simply save this article in your pocket account. And then later go to the mobile app and use the text-to-speak feature to listen to it. Obviously, the audio is kind of robotic and you may not like it at first. But with time, you will come to peace with it and started appreciating the content instead. And guess what? You can also listen to your ebooks or any other digital media. All you have to do is find a way to temporarily publish them on any website. You can use bloggers or WordPress for that. And then use the pocket account just like you would normally do. Number 2. Try Librivox. So let's say you want to try audiobooks, but apparently you don't want to spend any money. Well, in that case, Librivox is the best option. So basically it is an online community that has hundreds of free audiobooks. Most of them are under public domain. Now, what type of books are under public domain? Well, any book which is older than 120 years from today or after 70 years of author's death will automatically fall under public domain. Now I know, this is quite old, but if you can look well, then you can find some of the hidden gems. Like for instance, what I do is, I go through this popular public domain book list on Goodreads, and when I find something interesting, like this Adventure of Sherlock Holmes series, then I simply copy paste it and look for it in the Librivox. And by the way, I really enjoy this Sherlock Holmes series by Ruth and you should definitely check that out as well. Another thing that I like about Librivox is that in its smartphone app, you can either listen to an audiobook or even download it for offline use. And it also has a sleep timer and playback speed option, which is nice. So overall, it is a free audiobook app with some really good collections of classical books. And I highly recommend this to beginners. Number 3. Try the web. Now, if you're looking for some of the latest audiobook but cannot afford it right now, then you should definitely consider YouTube or SoundCloud. Now, finding audiobooks over there is not a piece of cake, but if you know basic Google FU, you can do it. Most of these audiobooks are questionable uploads, so don't expect them to stay for long. But if you want to grab them quickly, then check out the subreddits like audiobooks on YouTube. Now, once you have taken them offline, you can start listening to it on dedicated audiobook app. I prefer smart audiobook player. Now, the reason why I don't recommend normal music player app is because these audiobook player have more options. However, the important thing here is don't forget to support the author. You can do that by spreading good words about the book in the social media, or you can buy the physical copy when you can afford it. Number 4. Try podcast. Now, these podcasts are a little different from audiobooks. Consider them like a blog with audio or like a radio show where two experts are discussing an interesting topic. However, finding a right podcast is little different from finding a blog post because Google cannot index it. And this is why we need an app or a repository where we can find all the podcasts in a single place. So some of these popular apps or repositories are like iTunes, Podcast Addict or Pocket Cast. I use the last one. So once you open these applications, you can choose from several genres that interest you. And then you can subscribe to them just like you do with the YouTube videos. Now, whenever they will upload a new episode, you can just listen to them. Or you can also check the previous videos. Finally, if you're getting started with podcasts, remember to spend some time finding the right channel. Or you may find it boring and you will eventually quit it. Number 5. Audible. Now, even if you have never listened to Audiobook before, I'm pretty sure you have already heard this name. It is all over YouTube. So basically, Audible is an Amazon-owned company which has the biggest collections of audiobook recorded by some of the best voice artists in the industry. But this also comes with a steep price. For instance, there are two buying options. One, you can buy a book from Audible just like you buy a book from normal bookstore. Or second, you can do what most people do, that is subscribe to their 1 month service for $15 a month, and this way you will get a free audiobook every month. Now, if we take a look at the Audible mobile app, then you will see it has all the essential features like sleep timer, changing the playback speed, or even the bigger control screen which is useful while you're driving. You can also listen to your audiobooks offline. And yes, whatever you buy from Audible is yours to keep forever, just like you do with the physical book. But is it worth it? Well, I have been an Audible subscriber for a year now, and to be honest, it is a bit expensive, at least from Indian point of view. But finally, it also comes down to one single line, that is, spending money on books is the best investment you can make, plain and simple. So I have finally finished reading the autobiography of Elon Musk by Ashlee, Vance, and it was awesome. So if you're looking for something inspiring but also realistic at the same time, then check that out. I highly recommend this one. And guess what? If you sign up using my affiliate link, then you can also read this book or any other book for free. And then if you like the service, then continue it or cancel anytime in the first month. You won't be charged anything. So go ahead and sign up for Audible now. This way you get a free book and also the chance to support this channel. So this is all for now. It's Nirav signing off, and like always, thanks for watching.